Hello, welcome back. Long time no see. I hope you're safe and sound during this coronavirus pandemic. See what I'm wearing today? It's cheongsam, a type of feminine body-hugging dress very popular in Chinese culture. So can you guess our topic for today? Yes, it's something about China. Actually, it's Chinese influence over Vietnam. But before talking about this, let's take a brief look about Vietnam's history. Vietnam has a history as rich and evocative as anywhere on the planet. The American War in Vietnam, or Vietnam War to some, captured the attention of the West. But centuries before that, Vietnam had been in conflict with the Chinese, the Khmers, the Cham, and the Mongols. The history of Vietnam can be traced back to around 4,000 years ago. In South Vietnam, there was an Indian influence. From the 1st century to the 6th century AD, the southernmost part of Vietnam was part of the Indianized Cambodian kingdom called Funan. Funan was famous for its refined art and architecture. The Funanese constructed an elaborate system of canals both for transportation and the irrigation of rice. The principal port city of Funan was Ok Eo in the Mekong Delta. In the middle of Vietnam, an Indian-influenced state called Champa arose in the 2nd century AD. Like Funan, it adopted Sanskrit as a sacred language and borrowed heavily from Indian art and culture. By the 8th century, Champa had expanded southward to include what is now Nha Trang and Phan Rang. In North Vietnam, the Chinese ruled the region until the 10th century. Finally, in 938, a leader named Ngô Nguyên defeated the Chinese at the Battle of Bạch Đằng River. The purpose of China was to conquer Red River Delta, a geographical terrain for trading supplies with other powerful countries like India and the Roman Empire. And Vietnam was the key port of call on the sea route between China and India. During the time Vietnam was a Chinese colony, we adopted the Chinese writing system, Confucianism, arts, and literature. So, learning about Vietnam's history, we also need to learn about China, since Vietnam and China share a long and complicated history. Later came the French and the humbling period of colonialism. The Americans were simply the last in a long line of invaders who had come and gone through the centuries, and no matter what was required or how long it took, they too would be vanquished. People say the Vietnamese are fierce and independent. We have a long history of warfare. Visitors to Vietnam can't help but notice the same names pop up again and again on the streets of every city and town. These are our national heroes who, over the last 2,000 years, have led the country into victory over the foreign invaders. The Vietnamese have been traditionally forgiving and generous to their enemies. This is the reason why there is no hard feelings towards Americans now, and also a group of Chinese still live in harmony with us. In recent times, the ethnic Chinese have largely assimilated into the mainstream Vietnamese society due to similar traditions and religious beliefs. Okay, today's video, let's go and see how China influences Vietnam. Let's go! Hi! Now I'm standing in front of Hinh Hậu Pagoda. This is one of the oldest Chinese pagodas in Ho Chi Minh City. While the Indians introduced Theravada Buddhism to Vietnam, the Chinese brought Mahayana Buddhism, and the Vietnamese is mainly of the Mahayana school. I'm inside the pagoda. I visited the pagoda on a rainy day, so I get a bit wet. Now let's take a look around and see how it looks like. The pagoda was built around 1760 and it has all Chinese architecture characteristics. There are four houses linked to each other and a small yard among the houses. The pagoda has hundreds of antiques that appear since 18th to early 20th century. People said think how pagoda construction materials were brought from China. The roof is decorated with more delicately fashioned porcelain figurines expressing themes from Chinese religion and legends. Wow, a great incense burners. There's wooden statues, stone statues, all priest tiles, potteries, reliefs were transferred from China to Ho Chi Minh City by ship. It makes think how pagoda an important pagoda to the Vietnamese and the Chinese in Ho Chi Minh City also. Measuring has think how statue in the center. In today's Vietnamese culture, pagoda has become a vital part of life for the locals. They visit a pagoda to pray for safety, health, good luck, prosperity, and happiness. Besides pagodas, the Chinese also influences Vietnam in several aspects, many of which is the food. Let's check it out. There are some food that Vietnamese are much influenced by China. In many ways, there's a Chinese influence on the Vietnamese cuisine, such as noodles and bánh phở, from which we have a famous phở all over the world. Phở originated in the early 20th century in northern Vietnam and was popularized throughout the world by refugees after the Vietnam War. So I'm gonna eat my phở. Stay on the table. Green sprouts and some vegetables and my phở here. Let's eat. Phở is available everywhere in Vietnam, and one bowl of phở costs about 50,000 dong. And also Tết holiday that I made in the previous video, it is the most important celebration that is influenced from China. Tết was originally brought to Vietnam by the Chinese and was passed to the Vietnamese people and has stayed relatively intact through the centuries. Tết is generally celebrated on the same day as Chinese New Year. So that's all for today's video about Vietnam history and Chinese influence. For my next video, where would you like me to go? Leave a comment below. Thank you for watching. See you next week. Bye bye.